at the rhythm of the sun. Well, I was wide awake until the dawn upon her face, and the echoes of our song as it hummed along. So stay with me, stay with me, you are my missing pieces.
Hello, my friend. How are you today?
I'm a little sick. Good morning, everyone. I'm fighting a head cold that's coming in strong. But we haven't done BTS in over a month, and the last thing I was going to do is cancel. So bear with me. A little sluggish.
Remember when I had a cough for like 6 months? The first 6 months that we did this, I just had a constant cough.
But I was fine. So, you know, really wasn't that big of a deal.
You live in Florida. I live in New York.
Press buttons.
Oh man, how's everybody doing today? We got the fam
here. We got
here.
Our crew here. Hello, Army. Oh my goodness, we have so many people jumping in. Hello, hello, hello. There's a few things I do want to address. I was reading earlier when we post live events like this, for whatever reason. Until the actual event takes place, the comments that are left just disappear. It's like after 12 hours or 24 hours, something like that. I know a lot of you left some amazing comments and you're wondering where they went. Well, they were not deleted by any means, but it's just what YouTube does. So until it goes live, then it'll stick around. So well, I see that because Jill had some great information. We are slightly armed for today's song. Look at those guns.
The gun show.
In our last, I think where we left off a month ago, Spring Day was actually suggested, and that's the song that we're doing today. And this is the 10th anniversary of when the Seoul, I think I'm saying it correctly, disaster took place. Are you familiar with this at all, Johnny?
Not really.
I had to look it up, and the moment I looked it up on Wikipedia, it was like, oh, I did hear about this. So, and here, I'm going to start with that. So here's the plan. Let me back up. The plan today is we're going to watch the music video. Then we're going to watch the music video explained. The Italian Army put together an incredible video, so that way we can kind of absorb everything in a little bit. And then, because we always like live, we're going to watch the Tiny Desk version. So we're going to be here for a minute. So grab your coffee.
Yep.
Get something to sip on. We're going to dive in. We know this is just a sensitive song and topic as a whole. And we want to learn a little bit more about it.
Absolutely. Yep.
So I'm going to pull up right away before we get in just a little bit. So this is the sinking of the MV Seoul. It was a ferry in April 16th, 2014 in South Korea. This is a 6,800-ton vessel sent a distress signal. And so out of 476 passengers and crew, 304 died, including around 250 students from the Donwon High School in Anson City. And of the 172 survivors, more than half were rescued by fishing boats and things like that. And we're going to learn more about that. So that's the context. And I guess this song was, and correct me if I'm wrong, Army, but I believe they released the song without really saying what it was about. Is that correct? And it took like a long time through interviews that they finally kind of confirmed. I think it was just they just kind of did their art in their way and not trying to
exploit it
in any way, which is totally on brand for their personalities. But that's my understanding.
Yeah,
And that's kind of interesting in and of itself. So, yeah, let us know about that. And before we jump in, Johnny. Oh wait, I have buttons.
Yes,
you're Johnny. I'm Richard.
I'm Johnny. You're Richard.
I have another button to press.
Yes, before we get started, if you guys could be so kind.
What is this one?
as to look at this 404 page.
I don't know what that one's all about. Hold on. That's our... It doesn't exist. Wait, that's our Buy Me a Coffee link. Hold on. We need our Buy Me Coffee link happening.
Great. Another great start.
So, you know, I feel like the more organized we are, the more likely something's going to crash and burn.
So this is where I usually fill time with something. But as we discussed yesterday, we had our members meeting yesterday. We had our
diamond throwing these, yeah.
And it was brought to my attention that one of the days that I played a couple Elton John songs or whatever, there was copyright issues or something. So I've decided that I'm only going to play Dark, Ominous, Analogous.
No, you can play songs. I think it's for the length of time and you were singing with it. Although,
but either way, I think this is the way I want to go now.
Yeah, that definitely qualifies as Dark Anonymous. Anonymous.
Or we can just do our new ASMR approach. Just like...
We'll do a whole video on that. Sorry, I'm almost done testing here. See if I can get this going. Yo, and this is... Sonny wrote this too, so this is part of the... This is part of the information coming in. The actual song wasn't written about the disaster, but the music video was that. I forgot to bring that up too. I know that information came in as well. It wasn't necessarily inspired by that, but the music video was inspired by that. So they had a song that I guess overlapped it in some way. Is
okay.
That right?
Yeah. Piano Diddy. P. Diddy.
And that is actually one thing I can do. Like I can do the Dark and Ominous. That's about it. Well, I don't know why our Buy Me Coffee widget isn't working. Here's the good news, though. The Buy Me Coffee links still work, and you can still buy us a coffee and support the page. It's just not going to pop up on screen. So when they do appear... Johnny and I will address it because it'll still pop up on our phone when it happens.
Yeah.
So.
Yep.
Okay.
And also hit like and subscribe.
Yeah, back to our regularly scheduled program. There's that. And then also, speaking of that link, be sure to check out the description below so you can visit this page, help support and grow our Throga family, become a silver, gold, or diamond Thronely member. We have a new member, actually, diamond member. Her name is Sky. Welcome to the team. Also, check out the Throga.com page to learn more about the seven dimensions of singing and our online singing classes and the vocal gym.
Yes, indeed.
All right. So, we are going to start with the... video, the music video. It's just my Wikipedia. Here we go.
Yes, and thank you already to Latte Lover and Vera.
Yes, thank you
for your copies. Thank you for your support.
I'm going to sip on right now because it's
Richard's
my,
tired.
It's my
today.
Lifeblood at the moment. Okay, let's see where we go here. Captions on. I do. Is that V? I can't tell from.
Boko sipta, no mo esokashika, nanan uri kamipta. 다 이제 얼굴 바보는 것조차 힘들어지는 거니까
여긴 온통 겨울뿐이야 8월에도 겨울이 와 마음은 시간에 달려가네 홀로 남은 설국 열차 네 손잡고 지구 반대편까지 가 겨울을 끝내봐 그리움들이 얼마나 눈치를 내려야 그 봄날이 올까
발걸음을 떠드는 채 긴 먼지처럼 자기 먼지처럼 날리는 눈이 나라면 조금 더 빨리 내게 닿을 수 있을 텐데 난 꽃이 떨어져요 또 조금씩 멀어져요 보고 싶다 보고 싶다 보고 싶다
I don't know where to pause it because it's this continued feeling. It's not like, and here's the chorus and here it stops. It kind of like evolves. It just kind of like keeps moving forward, which is really interesting the way it's constructed. So I wasn't quite sure where to pause it. This song, I just noticed, 530 million views 7 years ago. That's crazy. And I can see partly why, even like that tragedy aside, the lyrics are written in a way that is really universal, right? In the sense of it could be relationship, it could be a love relationship, it could be obviously a lost family member or something like that. Mm-hmm. It kind of has that, I don't want to say wholesome because it's obviously, you're missing something, but it just has that, just that human thing that everybody can identify with on some level. But it's called Spring Day. So it's that feeling of, there's that loss, but looking forward to like almost like a reconnection, maybe.
Yeah. Well, I was going to say musically, it's got sort of that, you know, it's obviously it's a heavy subject matter. And the lyrics are a little bit more, you know, the I miss you type of thing. But there's also a hopefulness in the chord progression, too, you know, and the melody. You know, it's E flat, da 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 da. Da, da, C minor, da, 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 da. And then also the beat, you know, is pretty, it's still moving along. So it's like, it's just got the melancholy, but also the hopefulness happening simultaneously.
I think they generally have that. If you look back at most of the songs that we've done, there's always an element of like that positive spin or hope or positivity. And maybe that's just Hobby's influence because he's in the room.
Yeah, maybe.
But just obviously, you know, Aram wrote the song, but there is that, and I'm assuming he produced it as well, probably with P-Dog, but they have, there's always like, they're in touch with the idea of it's never ending. There's always a level of optimism that's built into what
tunnel.
They do. Yeah, which is great. As opposed to just going totally dark and just like, oh, I miss you, I'm sad, and that's it.
Yeah.
Which are most of the songs I wrote. When I was young, it was just like really dark and sad, and that gave me joy for whatever reason. But I like the way they do things in that respect.
And there's something to be said about not being too on the nose with stuff, even if it is like pertaining to like a heavy subject matter, which, like as we found out, wasn't specifically written for that. But you know, even when you're talking about something a little sadder, when you know if you don't kind of like pour it all in and like this is a sad song, you know, like if you can kind of balance it out a little bit with something, you know,
which is great.
Yeah.
Now I'm trying to look at look for the Easter eggs because I don't really know much about the tragedy other than the statistics and just obviously how awful it was. And I guess there's controversy as to why it happened with like crew and, you know, things like that. And we should get to all of that in the explanation video. But I know there's things happening amidst this. There's obviously it's reflective. I don't know what the train symbolizes per se.
Mm-hmm.
So that was kind of interesting. And just also there's a couple lines in here that stood out to me. Well, I'm going to keep it going.
Yeah.
and go with this, because we're going to revisit the song in its entirety as well. So I don't want to make too many assumptions, but
right.
But I like production wise, I like the pad. It's got like that breathy overtone kind of thing. So mm-hmm. For whatever reason, to me, maybe because of the visualization, it gave that sense of just like, you know, that train, just that there's like,
oh,
just that kind of sound.
I wonder if that was intentional. Overtones, yeah.
Kind of going with it. I just like that yeah. combination. I thought that was clever yeah. visually. Mm-hmm. I swear they can turn every one of their music videos into a full blown movie.
I know.
Just the level that's of production, the cinematography, the storytelling within it. It could just be like, I feel like we're watching a trailer for what could be a 90-minute thing.
Yeah, everything they do is so well done. Every aspect.
I guess because I'm looking for it, I'm like, maybe I'm just making things up in my head, but that whole washing machine, it almost looked like the portholes and like the ferry, just the way he looked into it. I might be over analyzing, but it kind of like that, like this, you know what I mean? Like it just has,
oh, possibly
the Easter egg. I don't know. And then right after that, that pile of clothes, just, I think symbolizing the loss of all the people.
Yeah.
So sorry, I'm looking for this stuff. And then as I'm doing that, I'm forgetting to actually read the actual lyrics, and then who's singing right now, and what the, you know, so.
But luckily
when we see Tiny Desk, we can see, you know, we'll probably comment more on the actual like vocal delivery of what's happening here, right? But there's a vulnerability tone wise and everything that's definitely present. Mm-hmm. I like the counter melody that they have. What is that? It's not, is that a synth or a guitar?
Let me hear it again. I'm not sure which one part you're pointing out.
It's kind of like, yeah, well, there's a lot of things going on because obviously the lead vocal, but I like how they have the vocal, and then I don't know if this was RM or P-Dog or whoever that came up with the line underneath it, because it's, I don't think it's the same thing that they're singing unless they're reflecting something that's earlier in the song. Yeah, kind of. It just
yeah. That's a synth line.
It's a synth line. I like the bend to it. It gives it like a little bit of a cry, mixed with it. But being up top, it like gives space for where the vocals are. So just the way they did the production there, I thought was really clever. It also keeps the song feeling like it's moving forward. It's moving forward, which is and they keep hinting at this, almost like it's like, you know, one of the members is lost and they get together. Almost like that it's like. See you again in heaven is kind of how I would interpret this, at least this version of it, as opposed to maybe it's originally written. You guys would know this. Did RM ever talk about, was this like a loss of like a death of a friend or family member, or is it just like a love, you know, just a breakup kind of thing?
Yes. And yeah. And we will be watching the explanation video too. So we're just trying to
we're going to do that next
blind take on it. And then we will watch it. Sure.
We're just trying to rack up as many things as we can think of to see how wrong we are, because that's our style.
Right.
All right, a little bit more here.
Yeah, beautifully done.
Oh, the music videos are always beautifully done. And the song, this is, how long has this been on the charts? I read something else too, that it's been like one of the longest standing chart songs that they had, and I'm guessing in Korea specifically.
Yeah.
570 million views on that one. I mean,
that's significant, yeah.
That's kind of a big deal. But it also has, like I said, the way it was written, the universality, the way it can be applied is just so relevant everywhere. So
yes
he was in the park when he wrote this.
It's charting still charting today. Wow
it's always in the South Korean charts. It never left. That's 7 years. Is that when? No, I mean, the tragedy was 10 years ago. So 7 years when it was released. That's got to be a record.
Yeah, I don't.
That's insane.
I don't even think Thriller did anything like that. That's, wow.
Wow, that's crazy. 7 years, babe. Dang. All right, so, so for this, I don't know how much we're allowed to show of this without risking having to throw this on Patreon or losing, you know, getting blocked in some countries, all that. So I know there's subtitles here. I looked ahead on mute. I never cheat. And I saw there's subtitles at the top and bottom. So I created a layer.
Okay.
That, so the middle part's going to be really faded. And so I apologize for that. If you haven't seen this, we will have a link in the description after this event. Mm-hmm. And you can go watch it in its entirety if in case you want to see a little bit more. But I just got it segmented so we can at least read what's happening.
Right. Okay. Yeah, this would be good to find out.
Yeah. Oh, by the way, thank you so much for the super chat as well from Be Artiful. We appreciate that very much. We love you too.
Benvenuti nel mio canale. Oggi analizzeremo insieme il video della canzone Spring Day dei BTS.
You're able to read that, John?
Spring Day è uno dei brani del nuovo repackage album Wings You Never Walk Alone. Se fate attenzione potete notare come il logo dell'album sia composto da quattro nastri gialli. Il nastro giallo è un simbolo universale, infatti lo trovate anche fra le emoji di WhatsApp. Può avere vari significati, ma per lo più è associato a coloro che attendono il ritorno di una persona cara. Rientra nella categoria dei nastri della consapevolezza, usati per esprimere sostegno a favore di cause e campagne civili. In particolare in Corea del Sud è stato usato come simbolo in memoria delle vittime del naufragio del traghetto Sewol, che avvenne il 16 aprile del 2014 e portò alla morte di 304 persone, la maggior parte delle quali studenti in gita scolastica. I BTS hanno recentemente fatto una donazione ai genitori delle vittime di questa tragedia, ma di questo parleremo più avanti. Ci sarebbe moltissimo da dire sulla questione, in particolare sul comportamento inaccettabile dell'equipaggio della nave e della guardia costiera, o sulla corruzione e negligenza del governo e della stampa, ma mi limiterò a riportare le vicende più gravi connesse al video di Spring Day. Osserviamo la scena iniziale del video. V si trova in una stazione che in Corea non è più in funzione da molti anni, ma si inginocchia appoggiando le orecchie sulle rotaie per sentire se il treno stia arrivando. Se ascoltiamo bene, però, possiamo sentire il segnale sonoro di una nave. Subito dopo, l'inquadratura segue un treno immaginario su dei binari vuoti. Il treno traghetto non arriverà mai e vi finirà per camminare tristemente in mezzo alle rotaie. Queste scene rappresentano il sentimento dei parenti e degli amici delle vittime, l'aspettarsi di veder comparire da un momento all'altro i propri cari come se nulla fosse successo, ma anche la loro richiesta, a lungo inascoltata, di riportare a terra il traghetto che si trovava ancora negli abissi assieme ai corpi di 9 dispersi fino a pochi giorni fa. Le prime parole della canzone sono «Mi mancate», mentre viene inquadrato il mare e Jimin che lo osserva. Poco dopo lo vediamo trovare delle scarpe sulla spiaggia, e notate anche come sono rovinati i vestiti che indossa. La scena fa quindi riferimento agli indumenti delle vittime, sia quelli persi in mare che quelli, come le scarpe che vedete, lasciati sul molo come tributo nei giorni immediatamente successivi alla tragedia. Da qui arriviamo alla scena nella lavanderia. Jimin si tiene accanto le scarpe come a rappresentare un amico che non c'è più. Se i vestiti simboleggiano le vittime, gli oblò delle lavatrici ricordano quelli di una nave, quindi anche le lavatrici rappresentano il traghetto, e i vestiti sono le persone intrappolate all'interno. I cestelli girano capovolgendosi, proprio come accadde al Sewol. Ascoltate cosa dice il testo della canzone in queste scene. Si riferisce all'ordine insensato che venne continuamente trasmesso ai passeggeri del Sewol e che fu una delle cause principali della loro morte. Sarebbe bastato saltare in mare per salvarsi. Solo in questi oblò, che poi vengono inquadrati da vicino, sono stati aggiunti degli adesivi con le istruzioni, dove non a caso l'unica frase leggibile è «Don't forget». Non dimenticare è uno degli slogan più usati per ricordare le tragedie, ma nel caso del naufragio del Sewol è un messaggio particolarmente significativo, perché alle famiglie delle vittime e ai ragazzi sopravvissuti fu più volte ripetuto di accettare e dimenticare l'accaduto. Guardate ora questa foto. Ritrae uno dei sommozzatori incaricato di recuperare i corpi delle vittime dentro la camera di decompressione. L'oblò non vi ricorda qualcosa? E quest'altra scena, in cui Jin inserisce la moneta per far partire la lavatrice, si riferisce chiaramente agli interessi economici e alla corruzione che sono stati la reale causa dell'incidente. Per farvi capire questa e le scene successive, devo fare una breve pausa e spiegare alcune dinamiche della tragedia. Il naufragio del Sewol fu causato dal peso eccessivo dovuto a delle modifiche illegali effettuate alla nave, che però aveva comunque ottenuto una licenza di circolazione. Alcuni membri del governo furono accusati di avere interessi finanziari nella società proprietaria del traghetto, ma le indagini furono portate avanti in modo poco trasparente e alla fine molti dei reali responsabili rimasero impuniti. Alcune delle responsabilità più gravi pesano sulla guardia costiera. Giunta sul luogo dell'incidente, dopo aver recuperato quelli che per legge avrebbero dovuto mettere in sicurezza i passeggeri, e cioè equipaggio e capitano, si premurò soltanto di impedire alle imbarcazioni civili accorse in aiuto di avvicinarsi. E nessuno dei soccorritori si introdusse nella nave o ruppe le finestre per liberare chi era intrappolato dentro. Alla fine la maggioranza dei sopravvissuti fu salvata dai pescherecci che riuscirono ad avvicinarsi. E intanto la nave continuava ad affondare, fino a che poche ore dopo divenne impossibile recuperare i passeggeri senza attrezzature per l'immersione. Nonostante ciò, la stampa, manipolata dal governo che non voleva perdere consensi elettorali, riportava alla nazione rassicuranti notizie false.
I pochi giornalisti che si recarono sul posto furono licenziati e subirono pressioni e censure da parte del governo.
In queste immagini si vede chiaramente come la guardia costiera abbia ostacolato e addirittura sabotato le operazioni di recupero di volontari esperti.
Unbelievable. 충분히 들어가려면 들어갈 수가 있거든요.
민간인들은 들어간대. 근데 경찰은 못 들어간대. 아무것도 하는 게 없어요.
potete quindi immaginare la rabbia, la frustrazione e il senso di impotenza dei genitori accorsi sul posto, sapendo che i loro figli, forse ancora vivi grazie alle sacche d'aria, stavano morendo a causa dell'inspiegabile mancanza di azione di chi doveva salvarli. Ritorniamo adesso alla scena nella lavanderia, dove l'orologio segna le 9.35. Tra le 9.30 e le 9.45 le apparecchiature di comunicazione del Sewol smisero di funzionare e l'equipaggio fu tratto in salvo mentre i passeggeri venivano abbandonati al loro destino. Poi compare Suga, seduto su una pila di vestiti che è praticamente identica all'installazione Person dell'artista francese Christian Boltaski che state vedendo. Rappresenta le persone che ci hanno lasciati. Nel video i vestiti sono circondati dall'oscurità che ricorda appunto gli abissi del mare. In quest'altra scena possiamo notare attaccati alla giostra decine di nastri gialli. Qui abbiamo un'altra prova di come l'intero video faccia riferimento al naufragio del Sewol, perché nei giorni successivi alla catastrofe tantissimi coreani mostrarono il proprio supporto alle famiglie coinvolte aderendo alla campagna dei nastri gialli. Luoghi e strade della nazione furono colorati di fiocchi giallo speranza. Anche la giostra non è stata inserita a caso. You'll Never Walk Alone è una canzone di scena di un musical di Broadway che si chiama appunto Carosello, e viene eseguita in due momenti, per confortare la protagonista subito dopo il suicidio del marito, che era appunto un giostraio, e poi come incoraggiamento verso la loro figlia che sta affrontando l'ultimo anno di scuola. Quindi abbiamo di nuovo i temi del lutto e del conforto. Vedete l'albero dentro il cerchio di luci che rappresenta la giostra? Simboleggia la vittima, ma anche il ciclo della vita, e questo ci ricollega anche all'albero della scena finale di Spring Day. E non è tutto. Questa canzone di scena è diventata l'inno ufficiale della squadra di calcio del Liverpool, che mostrò il suo sostegno alla campagna dei nastri gialli con il tweet che state vedendo. Proprio il giorno prima dell'incidente del Sewol, il Liverpool aveva infatti celebrato l'anniversario di un altro grande disastro, e lo aveva fatto come da tradizione, cantando il suo inno You'll Never Walk Alone. Sto parlando della tragedia dello stadio di Hillsborough, che provocò la morte di 96 persone, anche in questo caso molti dei quali ragazzi. Nel 2016 le famiglie delle vittime del Sewol hanno incontrato quelle delle vittime di Hillsborough, unendosi in una campagna comune. Questo perché in entrambi i casi la stampa corrotta riportò false notizie e i parenti delle vittime lottarono e lottano ancora per ottenere verità e giustizia.
돈도 필요 없고 보상도 필요 없고 심리 치료 다 필요 없거든요. 그것만 해주시면 대한민국의 안전한 미래가 여러분들의 손에 달려있다는 것 그거 하나만 명심해 주시고 제발 통화 주시시오.
Da tutto ciò capiamo che la scelta del titolo.
Yeah. Oh man.
Sorry, I just need to pause it for a second. Oh my god. I mean.
Yeah.
I'm not pausing for dramatic effect to react to anything. I'm just absorbing. Sorry.
Yeah. No, it just. It's just so heartbreaking. You know, you have a heartbreaking event in and of itself, and then when you compile it with just corruption and greed, making it so much worse. You
so
know?
Much worse. I mean, it's not something. It's just, it's in any government, right? It's we see this all the time here in the States too. Obviously,
it's just such like, a universal thing. It's just like we
follow
all
the money, follow the ego trip, follow the you know, and it and. Mm-hmm. You know, and the truth gets buried in these just awful scenarios that never should have happened to begin with. It's just
and just these poor victim, you know, the victims themselves, but you know, almost as bad as the you know the people that love the victims, their family members and their friends, which have to live with that forever.
I just can't. I mean, I can't help but view it from a parental perspective. You know,
yeah,
kids going on a field trip and not coming back. I mean,
I know. No, it's it definitely makes you count your blessings. You know, it's like you know, if you still have family members around, it's just man, just you cherish them.
In just a quick nod to BTS, and I mean they did this so tastefully, right? So they took a song that apparently already existed, already wrote it about whatever. We don't know. You guys might know that, but I don't know what that is. And then they did it in a way like we were thinking at the beginning. It's like it's just didn't exploit the tragedy in any way to get, it wasn't like, here's what this is, and this is going to help the ratings of the song. It's like, because some businesses, some artists are going to think that way. They're going to use that as a catapult for their music. It's done so tastefully. It's done respectfully. It's done out of, in an artistic way that still, allows you to interpret in any which way into your own life, just on a personal level, let alone something, a national, international tragedy such as this. Just kudos to them.
Yeah.
Un Hour Walk Alone non Absolutely. È stata affatto casuale. Un altro particolare è lo stato della giostra, arrugginita e rovinata proprio come le lamiere del Sewol sommerso, che è stato recuperato alcuni giorni fa, poco dopo la caduta del governo. Oltre a collegarsi al titolo del musical, quindi, anche la giostra rappresenta la nave che trasportava gli studenti. Nelle scene successive del video, credo sia stato rappresentato il momento della morte delle vittime. J.K. sta sognando, infatti indossa vestiti diversi. Corre cercando un'uscita e qualcosa non quadra, tutto trema, le tende svolazzano. Dopo aver attraversato la lavanderia, che come ho detto simboleggia l'inabissamento della nave, J.K. incontra gli altri membri del gruppo, ma qualche istante dopo si rivede dentro al treno traghetto. È come se la sua anima si fosse staccata dal corpo che è ancora lì, sul mezzo di trasporto. Se notate, il treno sta attraversando un tunnel, un passaggio, che simboleggia appunto il momento del trapasso. La luce diminuisce e vediamo J.K. e Rap Master che chiudono gli occhi e abbassano la testa nel tipico atteggiamento del lutto. Il fiammifero si spegne come le vite dei passeggeri del Sewol. Ma ecco che si riaccende, compaiono anche gli altri membri e tutti si ritrovano sopra la pila di vestiti che adesso non è più negli abissi dell'oceano, ma raggiunge il cielo dove in genere tendiamo a immaginare le persone che ci hanno lasciati. A questo punto J.K. si risveglia e tutto il gruppo arriva a destinazione. Questo che state vedendo è un video realizzato in memoria delle vittime del Sewol che mi ha ricordato moltissimo la scena finale. Le scarpe appese ad un albero rappresentano qualcuno morto in circostanze tragiche e la solennità stessa della scena fa pensare che i ragazzi stiano porgendo il loro omaggio davanti a un monumento ai caduti. Ricordate le scarpe e i messaggi che vi ho mostrato? In questa possiamo leggere. Tesoro, un tuo amico ti ha comprato un bellissimo paio di scarpe. La tua mamma, tuo fratello e tua sorella ti stanno aspettando. La scena trasmette un sentimento di memoria, solidarietà e conforto. Del resto l'intero video è studiato per dare questa sensazione. I colori sono tenui ma vividi, i luoghi sono liberi aperti oppure chiusi ma accoglienti. L'atmosfera ispira una serenità pacata come la neve, inducendo anche il ricordo di dolci momenti passati, come la scena della festa di compleanno. I momenti che state vedendo adesso rappresentano infatti dei ricordi, perché sia Jin che Bi li fotografano per poterli riportare alla mente in futuro. L'insegna che vedete fa riferimento a questo libro, che parla di una festa dell'estate nella città utopica di Omelas, dove tutti vivono felici. Questa felicità però ha un prezzo. Un bambino deve vivere segregato in un luogo angusto, da solo e malnutrito, in una condizione che lo porterà presto alla morte. L'insegna in rosso, che significa al completo, ci fa riflettere su come il benessere nella nostra società sia riservato solo ad alcuni. Il significato del racconto di Omelas può essere paragonato a quello del film Snowpiercer, a cui sia il testo che individua Spring Day fa un riferimento. Lo Snowpiercer è un treno che continua a muoversi attorno alla Terra, colpita da una nuova era glaciale. Tutti gli uomini sopravvissuti si trovano su questo treno, che è diviso in classi sociali. I più ricchi vivono nei vagoni anteriori, mentre i più umili nelle ultime carrozze. I poveri sono continuamente oppressi dai ricchi, che arrivano a rapire alcuni dei loro bambini, e per questo organizzano una rivolta con lo scopo di arrivare alla testa del treno e prenderne possesso. Ma una volta arrivati, scoprono che, per poter funzionare, il motore ha bisogno che dei bambini sufficientemente piccoli si occupino della sua manutenzione in condizioni terribili. Nel video, Omelas sembra trovarsi simbolicamente all'interno del treno. Si tratta della rappresentazione dei vagoni riservati ai ricchi, che vivono sulle spalle dei poveri e dei bambini sfruttati. Entrambe le storie sono quindi un'allegoria delle società capitaliste attuali, dove chi ha il potere è disposto a sacrificare degli innocenti per il proprio tornaconto. Il che è esattamente quello che è accaduto con l'incidente del Sewol.
Saramı salıyor. 사람이 살아있다고 갑자기 왔대. 빨리 구해줘 좀.
Dopo la morte di ragazzini innocenti ci fu uno scarico di responsabilità e una ricerca di capri espiatori. E così i volontari accorsi in aiuto divennero responsabili di aver ostacolato operazioni di soccorso inesistenti, furono inventate condizioni atmosferiche avverse alle immersioni e il governo fece persino in modo che la stampa dipingesse i familiari delle vittime come rivoluzionari affamati di soldi, nel tentativo di manipolare l'opinione pubblica contro di loro. Qui potete vedere come un giornalista stia fingendo di essere pressato dalla calca e come polizia e reporter stiano premendo sui manifestanti del tutto pacifici. La tragedia del Sewol e i nastri gialli sono per questo diventati un simbolo della lotta contro la corruzione del governo coreano. C'è un motivo per cui la Big Hit e BTS hanno scelto di affrontare questi temi proprio adesso. Negli ultimi mesi molti funzionari governativi e collaboratori della presidentessa Park sono stati arrestati per corruzione. La stessa Park è stata interrogata nel dicembre 2016 anche riguardo le sue responsabilità nella tragedia del Sewol e questo 10 marzo è stata destituita dalla sua carica e arrestata. È stata inoltre scoperta l'esistenza di una lista nera governativa contenente i nomi di quasi 10.000 artisti che sono stati discriminati e censurati per aver espresso idee politiche di sinistra o mostrato solidarietà alle famiglie delle vittime del naufragio. Nella lista erano presenti anche i nomi del regista del film Snowpiercer assieme a uno degli attori principali e questo ci spiega ulteriormente il riferimento a questo film nel video di Spring Day. Quelle che vedete sono le immagini delle proteste che sono avvenute in questi mesi a Seul. Le luci rappresentano la speranza nel futuro della Corea. Tutto il paese, nonché vari artisti, hanno fortemente espresso la loro opposizione al governo. Nello show che state vedendo, i rapper, al posto di sfidarsi tra loro, hanno attaccato all'unisono l'amministrazione Park, ricordando fra l'altro la tragedia del Sewol. Le parole di questo pezzo non vi ricordano un po' il testo di Spring Day? Anche i BTS e la Big Hit non sono rimasti a guardare. Hanno segretamente donato 100 milioni di won, circa 80.000 euro, all'Organizzazione per la Verità e per una Società Più Sicura, creata dalle famiglie coinvolte nel naufragio del Sewol. Nonostante la stampa non fosse stata informata, dopo il comeback la notizia è venuta a galla. La Big Hit ha confermato la donazione, aggiungendo solo che i ragazzi ritenevano la questione un affare personale. Alla conferenza stampa dopo l'uscita dell'album, Rapmaster ha dichiarato che con i 4 brani di You Never Walk Alone, i BTS vogliono mostrare la speranza e la rinascita della gioventù che proviene dalla lotta e dalla disperazione.
우리들도 젊은 사람들도 그 한국 사회의 미래를 생각하고 그런 능력이 충분히 있다고 생각하고 앞으로 더 나은 그런 대한민국을 만들기 위해서 훨씬 그런 노력을 할 수 있다고 생각을 합니다.
Ci sono molti simboli nei vestiti che indossano che rimandano a questi concetti. La tigre sulla maglia di V simboleggia la lotta, mentre l'ape, oltre ad essere un simbolo spesso associato alla rinascita come la farfalla e le fenici, è anche un simbolo di operosità e si presta bene a rappresentare i giovani coreani. Il fiore blu sul maglione di Jimin rappresenta la memoria e il ricordo, e poi ci sono le ali, l'aereo, le piume. Si tratta quindi di un messaggio di conforto e di speranza nella rinascita di un'intera generazione che lotta affinché gli errori, la negligenza e la corruzione della società non debbano più ricadere su di essa e su coloro che verranno. Sono infatti proprio i giovani che stanno più soffrendo e pagando a causa dell'organizzazione sociale coreana. Non a caso il tasso di suicidi fra gli studenti di questa nazione è fra i più alti al mondo. Alle domande riguardo i riferimenti alla tragedia nel video di Spring Day, Rapmaster ha risposto: «Siamo piuttosto cauti nel parlare del naufragio del Sewol, ma credo che in quanto cittadini dello Stato dovremmo sentirci responsabili. Abbiamo donato perché volevamo aiutare il progetto». Dopo quello che vi ho mostrato potete facilmente immaginare perché i ragazzi siano cauti, ma Rapmaster ha anche detto che i BTS non resteranno in silenzio riguardo alle ragionevoli questioni sociali e che contribuiranno a lottare contro questi problemi con la loro musica.
Yeah.
That is, well, that is the most I've read this year.
Yeah.
And then you take in the context and it's just like my brain couldn't keep up with everything, all the details. And I'm sure some of the interpretations from the music video, I mean, you know, I'm sure that's flexible, right? And you might take liberties and, oh, this means this or whatever, and there might be some opinions or whatever, but it still seems, it's very clear that what it was about in the there's some core symbolism that is pretty undeniable, I think.
Yeah, well, that watching that helped so much, and I, you know, I just want to take a second. Not that I feel like I did anything wrong, but I feel like I just want to apologize for not being as sensitive to it in the beginning. Like, you know, it's like I just without
the
knowing
song itself.
Well, it's like it's, you know, when you hear, okay, when you talk about a tragedy that happened, it's like obviously you're sympathetic and you're like, oh, you know, that's awful, you know, but it's like hard to grok it, feel it until you see like those live scenes
where
the people just you know at their wit's end and just, well, I mean, they're
but that's the insanity of it, right? I mean, we get numb to tragedies happening every day. This
yeah.
Earthquake happened here. This blew up over here. This just every day.
And for your own sanity, you almost have to like separate from it a little bit and compartmentalize and like not overthink about it. You know, because you would just be totally, you couldn't function. Live. Like you'd just be drowned by it. But, you know, so I mean, I don't want to say that I was like goofing around, but it's like seeing it. And it, like just it, the context of it is just hitting home more. Yeah, it's like it's such a heavy subject, you know.
It's the heaviest we've taken on. I mean, we've definitely taken on songs that stem from tragedy or may have been about a specific thing. But this is the first time on this channel we've watched like live news footage or something like that. And it's, there's a reason I generally don't watch the news.
Yeah, I know.
It's like. There's so much drama in all of our little bubbles that we try to pedal through as best as we can, you know, day to day. And then, you know, and in our channel, we always try to keep things positive because it's just, even with our critiques of singers, things like that, it's like there's, everybody has something negative to say in their opinion and everything like that. But there's always something positive that we can pull out as well. And we try to celebrate that. But you need these moments too to give the relativity of why a spring day and hope is so necessary. Like we have mm-hmm. to have something to move forward to, or hopefully in what RM, what they were showing, what RM was talking about is just speaking up and like wanting to have positive change and to evolve, you know, even mm-hmm. on a government level, if, you know, when and where possible. So.
Yeah. It's just, it's like, and sometimes you can't even put words to watching something like that. Cause it's so, there's such a primal hurt that takes place, and you know, just as far as sadness, but also like the anger of the,
oh,
the unnecessary way that these officials handle these situations. And it's like how does that happen? You know, first of all, it's like, you know, just the universal age-old questions, like why do bad things happen like this anyway to people that don't deserve it,
right?
Especially children. And then on top of that, why, like, how can people that are in a position to help do the exact opposite? Like, how can they live with themselves?
Oh, there's like bad weather coming. We can't, you know, help save people literally alive right now, but currently drowning, or, you know, hoses being cut, the sabotage, like all those.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a specific example, but these things happen just every day somewhere on some level.
Yeah. Yeah, and just, I mean, again, just going back to BTS, I mean, it just speaks volumes of their humanity and what they do. You know, it's not just entertainment for them. Like, they really have taken their success and transformed it into something that's so good and so helpful and so hopeful for people. So it's, yeah, they're amazing.
Yeah. So I'm going to switch over. There's no smooth transition from this. It's just,
I know.
It's heavy. It's heavy. I'm glad we did this. So, I mean, again, today's 10 year anniversary from this, and you know, that the never forget. I'm so, and I apologize. I don't remember who reached out to us, and for whatever reason, it caught my attention. I think it was in a comment. It said, you have to react to this song on this day, and they were just, the way they wrote it was so adamant, it grabbed my attention. I'm so glad we did that to like bring light back to this.
Mm-hmm.
important song, and the fact that it hasn't left the chart and everything in 7 years too goes beyond this tragedy, but also again it just shows how people can connect to it, you know, day after day to keep it going in that way. Mm-hmm. So as promised, we're going to watch a live version of the song too, and we can kind of experience the song from a whole new perspective again.
Yeah. Oh, but I'm so glad that I watched that, for sure.
And thank you for all the chat. There's no way I could go over and kind of like read what you guys are talking about.
Yeah.
Read what was on the screen. So like after, I'll go back and read what you guys were doing. I'm sure I missed some great information, but and so thank you for sharing that. Mm-hmm. Well, I'll have to go back and read that. So.
Yeah.
And to answer, yes, we are going to watch Tiny Desk. I'm so glad you brought it up. I'm just going to see that in the chat now. Wait, this is 14 minutes. Oh, there's three songs. Dynamite, I mean, we could just watch them all. We don't have to do the one.
Let's do it.
Maybe a quick pause from this song. recalibrate my brain. Go check something else out and then return. Are you guys cool with that?
Yeah.
It's only 14 minutes. I can do it.
Also, just take a second to thank Chris and Lucy K for your support. Buy me coffees. And Francesca for becoming a Diamond Thronely member. Good to have you.
Diamond member.
Yeah. Yay. So diamond members are cool because so we have.
Well, first of all, you're all cool. But
yes, yes, yeah, you're all cool.
You're cooler.
It's cool for us.
There it is.
To have a Diamond Thronely member because we get to actually meet them in person, and we had a Zoom meeting yesterday with some of our Diamond Thronely members, and it's so fun, and it's so fulfilling to actually get, you know, match the faces with the names and to meet them and get to know the personality and for them to kind of get to know each other too.
Yeah. Which is pretty cool.
Which is cool. Yeah. I love it. It's such
that was great. Cool. So, and we do that every month. So it's one of the perks of a Diamond membership. And before we jump into here, Brittany, thank you for your super sticker as well. Greatly appreciate that. Okay.
Oh, so, okay. First, you ready?
I need a brain reset.
Yeah.
Dynamite, Save Me. Save Me, I feel like we... I'm just looking at the titles. I feel like we reacted to Save Me the past, but I mean, not Tiny Death, so we'll watch it again. But Dynamite, I don't think we did. Let's see what's going on. Oh, do I need to fade this? I do not want this kicked off YouTube. I'm going to be cautious. So just in case, because if we're on, this is NPR Music. I don't know what their rules are with they allow us to watch the whole video and there's no complications, but I'll try to keep my arm out of it. Johnny, watch your bicep.
They're just so massive.
They're so massive. This way we can enjoy this. And if you haven't seen this video, please, of course, we're going to add the link in the description. You can go and watch the original. Live is more likely to get hit with copyright issues than if it was pre-recorded. So we're just going to take an extra thing here. And yes, we are doing the whole thing. All right, let's go. Dynamite.
Because I'm in the snatch tonight. So watch me bring the fire, set the night light.
JK!
Hey!
Shoes on, get up in the morning, cup of meat, let's rock and roll. King Kong, kick the drum, running on like a Rolling Stone.
Uh-huh.
Sing song when I'm walking on, jump up to the top, LeBron.
Hey!
Ding dong, call me on my phone, nice day, and I get my ping pong.
Hey!
And my ping pong.
Hold on.
You guys are saying we definitely don't need to filter, so I'm just going to, in the air of caution, I'm going to filter it halfway. We're gonna do a little compromising here.
John needs to get a tattoo sleeve. Yes. That's from Art Throglodyte Noxon.
Throglodyte. Hold on. All right, so I'm gonna meet you halfway, guys. Just please allow me to be cautious here. I get nervous.
Forgive my absolute ignorance here. I know the song. Is this their song, or are they covering it? Did you say that?
Oh, do you know this one?
Yeah. This is a popular song, yeah.
Hold on. Opening with Dynamite, the group's first single to hit number one in the U.S.
Okay, I did not know that was
We
them.
haven't heard this, have we?
Yeah, that's a huge song. I mean, that was. I've heard it many times, yeah.
Okay. Oh, and then let me keep reading. The Breezy Proplosive Save Me from 2016 ultimately gave way to a full on power ballad.
It's their song, yeah.
To Spring Day. Oh, wild. Okay.
I had no idea. How old is this song?
Well, I don't know. Well, then maybe it's in here. I'm guessing someone in the chat will be able to answer that before I can find it.
Okay. Well, let's keep going with it, but that helps.
Yeah, that's cool. All right, let me start it up again. One more time.
Yep. It's a great pop song.
One more cup of meat, let's rock and roll. King Kong, kick the drum, running on like a Rolling Stone. Sing song when I'm walking on, jump up to the top, LeBron. Hey. Ding dong, call me on my phone, nice day, and I get my ping pong.
Okay.
Hey, this day, heavy, can you hear the bass, boom, I'm ready. Life's sweet as honey,
baby, yeah,
this beach chain like money. Huh. This call of love, I'm into that, I'm good to go, I'm diamond, you know I glow up. Hey, so let's go. Cause I'm in the stars tonight,
yep.
Hey. So watch me bring the fire, set the night light.
Hey.
Be shining through the city with a little fucking soul.
Gentlemen, I got the medicine, so you should keep your eyes on the ball.
Hey. This is getting heavy. Can you hit the bass? Boom, I'm ready.
Woo-hoo.
Let me sweet as honey. Yeah, this beat your chain like money.
Hey.
Disco, I'm alone, I'm in today. I'm good to go, I'm diamond. You know I glow.
Hey. Let's go!
Hey. Cause I'm in the stars tonight.
Okay.
Hey. So watch me bring the fire, set the night light.
Watch me bring the fire and set the night alight.
Hey!
Shining through the city with a little fucking soul. Light it up like dynamite.
One, two, three,
four. Cause I'm starting tonight. Watch me bring the...
Okay. This right here... Wait, I lost it already. Hold on. Joy. I dare you. They're like, you can't. You can't not.
Failed.
Total fail. Well,
God, we needed that song. Jeez.
Oh, my goodness, right? We're still coming back to Spring Day, but whew.
Yeah, but just to... Yeah. Oh, my God.
No, this is so that much is fun. I just love the playfulness.
That's like a perfect pop song.
Yeah, the camaraderie between them and everything. Oh, I think you've got a little bit of a delay. Say something.
Hello?
Dude, yes, I do. Bit. A little bit.
Okay.
That's right.
It'll come back.
Yeah. All right. Let's keep bobbing. My old
okay,
man
let's keep
bop.
Bobbing.
So watch me bring the fire and set the night alight.
Hey!
Shining through the city with the little fucking soul. Light it up like dynamite.
One, two, three, four.
Look at
nice.
Start
harmony at the end there too.
Oh, they're so fun. And
okay. Here we are.
Obviously, they're not playing in front of a big crowd based on the sound of the claps, but it's still they're performing as if they're playing for. Well, it's actually they're not overperforming too. It's like just perfect. It's like, you know, they're not like, oh, there's only 10 people here, but they're also not like,
which is easy to fall victim to sometimes.
Yeah,
for sure. It's just because there's a camera and you know there's people out there watching. It's very different when you've got like that visual interaction.
That's just the perfect balance of like little laid back, playful to the people that are
in the band, as per usual. I mean, they hire nothing but the best. I mean, their sense of timing, just the funk playing with everything, and just their interactivity that they're doing, even like the ghost note stuff going on the snare, and just the bass lines, everything is just solid.
Joy, I'm 74 and I'm jiving. We're all jiving.
Absolutely.
Okay. Here we are.
BTS. We just play our latest single, Dynamite.
Boom.
It's a disco pop track that we simply wanted to share a great energy to everyone around the world.
Yeah, it's the first time we are performing Dynamite with a live band.
Yeah.
By the way, we don't hear a lot. I mean, for V, I mean, obviously we've heard a lot of versatility over the course of several songs.
Right.
His chest voice push on this one was great because it didn't. A lot of times when you get up, how high was he going?
Let's see.
I'm just literally pecking on random notes as if I can find it.
So well, after they do the key change, which goes up to E flat minor, that's an E flat.
Yeah, that's up there. But he has it's a push that still has like the positive energy. It's really easy when you go that loud on the higher notes. It just sometimes it just comes across as a little bit yelly or like you're angry. But he kept just the smile intact. You know what I mean? So it kind of had like that funness with it. So it's easy for singers to kind of tilt the wrong way tonally there. I thought he did great on that.
Yeah. Also, this song has a great melody, and to me, what separates a great melody from not like a not so memorable melody is the fact that you can play it and without the words, and people know what it is. You ever played that game? It's called Heads Up. It's on the phone.
I know of it.
Yeah. So basically, you know, you hold up the song, and it lists the song, and the other person is to hum the song without words. And some songs are really difficult to point out when the words aren't there. And other ones, like pretty much every Beatles song, everything that's like super melodic, it's so much easier just because there's that footprint, that identifiable footprint in the melody.
Right.
With the melody, with the rhythm, the phrasing, and the note selection.
I feel like you would be scary good at that game.
I'm very good at that game.
We should play that game. During one of our...
We should.
I will need all of your help in the chat. It'll be us against Johnny. I feel like maybe we can win.
I feel like if there's anything that I was born to do, it was play that game. Live for all to see.
Let's keep going here.
Thanks to our awesome band who's here with us today.
Uh-huh. Also, we loved watching Tiny Desk performances, and we are very, very, very honored and excited. Mm-hmm. Yeah!
That's right. Everyone could also enjoy our tiny, but not so tiny concert. So up next, our next song is called Save Me.
Yeah. I can't remember if we heard this one yet.
Here we go. Let's go. Save go. Me.
Yeah.
Please. We heard the last one, we just didn't know it.
Are you ready?
Hey.
Mommy.
Hey.
Can you hear me?
Let's go.
난 숨쉬고 싶어 이 밤이 싫어 이젠 깨고 싶어 꿈속이 싫어 내 안에 갇혀서 난 죽어 있어 Don't wanna be lonely Just wanna be your
왜 이리 깜깜한 건지 네가 없는 이곳은 위험하잖아
Is this normally Jungkook's solo song? For some reason, my brain's telling me that this was one of... Hold on. I've heard part of it.
Britannia, so we have heard part of it, yes. Right.
Okay.
You heard it with in your first group reaction with them. Okay, so that like medley of songs. Okay.
Okay, all right. I was thinking it was a solo piece. I don't know why.
You guys don't wanna be lonely, just wanna be your
way to get him and gunji. Nigam the nigos and we imagine mangajin the mosu. Go ahead, you know, that don't have ever so absurd. So absurd. Nashim jung so out of the bar. Chemo teru nor put it on
there. 너는 이렇게 빛나니까
그 손을 내밀어줘 say I need your love before I fall.
Yeah. 그 손을 내밀어줘 say me, say me. I need your love before I fall. Fall.
그 손을 내밀어줘 say me, say me.
Oh. 그 손을 내밀어줘 say me.
Here we go.
Two, three,
let's go.
Hey. Save me, save me.
Uh-huh. Let's go.
Yeah.
Hey.
Save me, save me.
Sugar.
너는 다르다르 뱉나 내 기억 속에 뱅카오 나 닦여버린 일로 나 take play Sammy tonight play Sammy tonight play Sammy tonight 이 책이 어린 각 속 나를 구원해주리 나
알아주 알아주
너란 구원이.
I don't know any other rapper that I've heard that has he's got the coolest I hate to say squeak because that kind of like makes it uncool. Joker's got a great squeak.
Yeah, that's not usually seen as a positive thing.
But I love it when he does it. It's just such a cool characteristic
thing. Yeah, I know what you're saying.
That I don't hear anybody else do it.
Yeah.
The best of me, best of me. And the back of me. I dash you so sweet, I don't know that you're not so real.
Fire. 심장소리를 따라봐 제멋대로 널 부르잖아.
Yeah, I love his voice.
Jim and Joe,
it's
bad. He's just got more of like the
aerial voice. I need your love before I fall.
His hand is just save me, save me. I need your love before I fall.
Jim sounds great.
His hand is just save me, save me.
Yeah. It's hard to hear.
Go
one,
yeah. It's hard to
are you not picking up on it? So well, it also might be panned to one side because I'm deaf in one ear, so I'm only hearing everything completely on the left side. So if it's pan there, it's going to jump out a little bit more. But they're having a ball in the background, but it's not taking over the leads by any means.
So we've heard this song before. What a totally different experience watching it now that we know so much more about them individually. Is
it does make a difference.
We had no idea what we were watching before. No, we didn't know. But yeah, just to see their own. Yeah.
'Cause 손을 내밀어 just save me, save me. I need your love before I fall.
Let's go. One.
'Cause 손을 내밀어 just save me, save me. 'Cause 손을 내밀어 just save me, save me.
Okay, RM.
Let's go. Let's go.
고마워 내가 나에게 해줬어 내가 나에게 해줬어 이런 게 나에게 줬어 꼭 잊혀던 나에게 줬어 답답하던 나에게 줬어 꿈속에만 사던 날 깨워줬어 널 생각하면 나에게 없어 슬픔 따위 나에게 줬어
Thank you
우리가 돼줬어 Thank you
그 손을 내밀어줘 save me, save me
It's a distinct tone when he jumps in.
Yeah, he really does.
그 손을 내밀어줘 save me, save me I need your love before I fall.
Thank you.
Woo. Yeah.
Wow.
저희가 또 세이미를 이렇게 오랜만에 부르게 되었네요.
진짜
오랜만이네요. 네네. 네.
감사합니다.
특히나 이게 또 밴드의 편곡을 해서 하니까 또 느낌이 또 색다른 것 같아요. 어땠어요?
어우 너무 색다르네요.
신선합니다.
네. 또 오랜만에 해서 또 좋네. 너무 신나게 했고.
그러니까 네. 옛날에 이제 밴드 형님들이랑 같이 콘서트 다닐 때가 생각이 납니다.
새록새록하네요.
재밌었는데 그때. 네.
춤을 안 추니까 답답하다.
진짜 재밌었어.
네네 그러니까요.
다음에 또 퍼포먼스를 함께 또 보여드릴 기회가 있으면 좋겠네요.
예. 맞습니다.
Okay, all right. The next one is Spring Day, and I believe as such difficult time like now we all are wishing for the Spring Day to come.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Let's go.
All right. Re-experience this here.
It's been the roughest summer ever, but we know that spring. Will come. So let's go together. Let's go.
보고 싶다 이렇게 말하니까 더 보고 싶다 너의 사진을 보고 있어.
I'm assuming, sorry, I'm going to back it up to hear the verse again. I'm assuming all the voicing that they're doing live matches what we heard in the music video. I mean, I think that's usually the case from what you guys have shared with us before, but if it's different, I'm curious, let us know, but I'm guessing it's the same.
Let's go.
보고 싶다 이렇게 말하니까 더 보고 싶다 너의 사진을 보고 있어도 보고 싶다 너무 약속한 시간 나는 우리가 밉다 이제 얼굴 한번 보는 것조차 힘들어진 우리가
여긴 온통 겨울뿐이야 8월에도 겨울이 와 마음은 시간이 달려갔네 홀로 남은 설국열차 네 손잡고 지구 반대편까지 가 겨울을 끝내고 봐 그리움들이 얼마나 눈처럼 내려야 그 봄날이 올까
하고 온게 떠드는 자의 긴 먼지처럼 자기 먼지처럼 날리는 눈이 나라면 조금 더 빨리 내게 탈 수 있을 텐데 눈꽃이 떨어져요 더 조금씩 멀어져요 보고 싶다
보고 싶다
보고 싶다
I commented on this before, I just want to point it out again. Yeah, and this is one of the distinctions with group singers that pay attention to each other. You can hear Jungkook, like he's like chest voice kind of build up. He sets down the last two syllables as he hands it off to the next singer, and it picks up right there.
Yeah,
so they're always, I don't know how conscious they are of this. They might have been early on. I just feel like it's just intuition at this point. They're just
probably intuitive,
to the
yeah,
song.
I was gonna
yeah.
say.
But
yeah.
I always enjoy their ability to do that.
Sing, 멀어져요, 보고 싶다,
보고 싶다,
보고 싶다,
보고 싶다.
얼마나 기다려야 또 몇 밤을 더 세워야 널 보게 될까,
널 보게 될까,
만나게 될까,
만나게 될까.
다시 봄날이 올 때까지 꽃 피울 때까지 그곳에 좀 더 머물러줘 머물러줘
We miss you on me
기빈 the dedication we need of the song to Army during COVID
네가 변한 건지 아니면 내가 변한 건지 이 순간 흐르는 시간조차 미워 우리가 변한 거지 뭐 모두가 그런 거지 뭐 그래 믿다 네가 난 떠났지만 단 하루도 너 잊은 적이 없어 지난 솔직히 보고 싶었던 게 많았지 그게 너 원망하기보단 너라고
진이 널 불어내본 나 연기처럼 하얀 연기처럼
눈꽃이 떨어져
probably sucking the life out of the build up here, but what is going on with the chord progression? We've heard this each time. It's stepping outside of the key, doesn't it? Like it switches like a minor feel right before it does that lift. Dun, da, da.
Is it the chord,
or is it just the way the melody falls?
So, in the beginning of the song, so the song is in E flat major. Da, 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 da. So G minor. Da, 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 da. So, let me name those off again. Sorry. So E flat, G minor, C minor to A flat, and then later on, instead of the A flat major, they go to A flat minor.
Okay. Da, 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 and then the melody follows that in a way. Because I love the way it syncs. Not pun intended.
Right.
But then it has, so it's like that down feeling, and then it's that hope. It's like a springboard. I like the way that's constructed. Every time that happens, I really enjoy it.
Yeah, I like it too because it's very, very beatly.
Thank you.
Yeah, I know that.
Thank you for joining us, everyone. Thanks for having us, Tiny Desk Concert. Woo!
Thank you, our dear Army, as always. Miss you all, and here we are.
BTS! Thank you.
They're so likable, and it's so funny because RM, like, he's noted as being like the father figure in the band. When he talks, it's like you get that impression.
It's
too.
A sense of authority, just a little bit, right?
Yeah. He's just like, he's the grown up in the group. You know, it's like kind of speaks to everybody a little bit. Also, I know that Jin is. I think the story with Jin was it took him a little longer to develop his voice, like it wasn't as natural or something. Actually, he was discovered walking off a bus, I think it was, just because he was cute. So singing-wise, it took him a little bit longer
They're
to develop.
They're all annoyingly beautiful.
Yeah, I know, right? but what I was going to say is, like, whatever he did worked, because I love his voice. He's got such a... I love how it cuts, and it's different from the other voices. Like, the main, you know, Jungkook and Jimin. You know, Jungkook, Scott, and V. You know, Jungkook's got the more like conventional, like, you know, bigger voice, like big broad tone. He's got some of the runs, like the, you know, the chest voice, belty parts. Jimin's got that unbelievable tenor voice, you know, hitting the high falsetto parts, the head voice parts. And then Jin just kind of cuts in there so nice. He's just like, just got a little bit of that, like, more cutting tone. I don't even know how to describe it. Just a little bit thinner, but it's like, you know, but it's beautiful.
Yes.
And then V's got his crooner style.
Yeah, well, I mean, that's the thing. It's like we keep coming back. There's always something they add a new element of their personal flavor. And the uniqueness of the band, I think as a whole, not to say others don't do this, but successfully can branch out on their own with their own style, their own genre, their own albums.
Mm-hmm.
Like individually successful.
Yeah, they're all
back.
Stars. In
usually,
right. Yeah.
It's like, you know, like the band Kiss. They all did their own album, and it's like some of them got kind of left behind as far as the success level or whatever. And I obviously they still had the support from the Kiss Army, and it was a ironic lead-in as an example. Yeah. But they just do it so successfully, and then when they come together, it's like all those pieces just fit so well.
I like that. I like that you referenced Kiss.
I have no idea why my brain went in that direction. I never really got into the band at all. My favorite was the drummer, Peter Criss. Beth, I hear you calling, but I can't come home right now.
Yeah,
I like
no,
that
I just.
Song.
It's true. I love the bands where, you know, it's like no member is replaceable. You know, it's just they all. Right. You know.
Yeah. So I have time to do one more song.
Okay, let's do it.
Okay, so here's the challenge. What do we do next? So I'm hearing, so I see live performance with choreography. And another one that came
who's
through.
Who's Corey?
I wasn't sure. Choreography. And the other one that we would be able to do, yeah, no one was expecting a Kiss reference, including my own brain. There's also a cover of an artist named Sohee, which I think she's friends with the band, and she'd won. That was another one that was suggested for Spring Day specifically. So here, I'm just going to make a quick poll. I'm going to let you guys decide. Because I don't have time to do and both, but...
Real quick, I want to just thank RJSCH. I think that's just an acronym, or else your name is... I'm running out, actually.
Whoops.
For becoming a Gold Throne member. Nice to have you along.
Yes,
for this
welcome.
Wild and crazy ride that we are on.
Have time, crazy guys. But... Okay, so I'm going to put up a quick poll. What is last song? So we're going to do cover by Sohee. We got live with... Is Film Out? Is that the... I don't know what it is. I'm just going to type in Film Out because you guys are telling me to. And what's another option? Choreo or Film Out. So we're going to say live / choreo. Watch these be the same thing. So choreography. Is it the same thing as Film Out or two different things?
Film Out. Dum,
dum, dum. And then there's... All right, those are the ones I'm seeing the most. So I'm just going to put it in. Y'all can... fight over it because I don't know. And it doesn't mean we can't watch more later. We do have a tendency to circle back. Oh, Crystal Snow, that was another one that was suggested. Hold on. Is that the same song or is it a different one? There's way too many suggestions coming in now. This is so dangerous. All right.
Pandora's box.
All right, I'm letting you guys pick. Cover by Sohee, Film Out, live choreo, spelled C-H-O-R-E-I now, because Korea, and Film Out. Film Out, oh, it's a different song. All right, well, you know, you can vote on that too then. This is the last one we're able to do today. If that's what y'all want to hear, then that's what we'll do.
Let's do it.
We're here for you.
We are.
Is Crystal Snow also a different song? How much time we should we give him? I'm setting my timer. I'm giving you 2 more minutes. Two minutes starts now.
All right. In the meantime, tell me songs to play.
Well, how about Cheers? I read your mind. It's a little Johnny medley. Yeah, if Crystal Snow doesn't make it today, doesn't mean we can't watch it another day. All good. So it's like Film Out's like staying heavily in the lead here. We have it at 279 votes. Film Out is well in the lead. So I'm going to start looking. The timer isn't up, but I'm going to start looking for the length of that one. Is it on Hype? Hype label?
And in the end, oh, play some Les Miserables. Let's see.
Sorry, I'm searching for songs in the background.
Oh, If I Fell by the Beatles, yeah.
If I fell at all, and I
see the live.
Not had if I love you too, oh please, don't worry.
I'm having trouble finding the film out live. Was in vain. What location? What should I look up exactly? For some reason, I'm not able to find it. There it is. Time is up. Ending the poll. It has been decided.
Okay.
But I still don't have the link. We'll do Crystal Snow in the future. No worries. Bang Tang Music Blood. Alright, I'll do it there. Thank you.
I prefer all Beatles, Justin. But I think I like the later Beatles better. Song.
You left me waiting here a long, long time ago.
Don't sing too much. We have another. I'll have to deal with the copyright again. You just give little hints of the song. All right, so let me share the screen. Do I have the right one, y'all? Is this correct? Does this look right? Pink Floyd. What Pink Floyd do we got?
I'm sitting. And I remember the horizon.
That looks like we got the right one.
Okay.
Yeah, links don't copy paste in the chat or whatever. I've tried to alter that, but for some reason it doesn't let me. Okay. We gotta get to the song because I am limited on time. Johnny, watch your bicep. Let's not flood the we'll see as much of this as we can here. Alright, here we go. I know nothing about this song.
It's
in Japanese, okay. So gentle there.
That's
cool.
Never seen his hair like that before.
Yeah.
When you can sing the melody immediately back, it is well crafted. It's the first time I heard it, I'm like, I already know it.
Yep.
Well done.
He got him on, he's almost someone not colliding. Who has it done?
Let me rephrase that. When I can sing the melody back, you do it all the time. You hear something, you just play the whole dang thing on the piano. But for me, sometimes it's impressive.
Yeah.
Sorry. Let me start that verse over again.
He got him on. He's almost so we're not colliding. Who has it done? I'm on. Not Chicago. I'm not
優しく君の名前笑ってて欲しかっただけ名乗り連れ直れ涙も両方で涙だ君遅ればせながらやっと今君の隣まで追いついて見つけたのさ
How does the tone not break there? He's so good at that.
I know, really is. I don't remember the last time I've actually seen him with his natural hair color either.
Oh,
it's always got a different color.
But the eyes are always changing a little still.
Yeah, that's right.
But going to the F with just the it's like the warmness that's there. It doesn't just like flip into like a Mickey Mouse tone. Like
right.
When I do it, just kind of has just this just generic puberty switch in that space. It just that's cool.
Yeah.
Nice.
I love the live versions.
Oh, I do too. The layers were fantastic in just how they do this often. Well, they'll have they do octaves often as a kind of like support, right? So you got like the higher part and then an octave under, maybe sometimes two under, you get like some of the lower parts. And then their choices in between always gives it just a little bit of musicality, right? And it's just, it makes it so much more interesting than just having like a gang vocal where they could just all follow the same thing. And of course we expect that when you've got four lead singers, but I mean, all seven can sing and support that too. But typically the four, I like, they take advantage of that in the right spaces. So rather than like an a cappella group that you'd kind of hear like that wall of layers the whole time, with most other groups, you can hear it just in the choruses here and there, which they do, but every once in a while they layer it into the verses and the bridge. It just keeps you just guessing little bit.
There's always something going on in their songs. Yeah.
Always.
It's the thing. Never a dull moment.
I have to say,
always something interesting.
I started this feeling under the weather. BTS has healed me. I feel much better now.
It's a miracle.
It's a miracle. Hallelujah. I'm like, oh, my throat's. I mean, the medicine would have worn off by now, too. I need to listen to more.
I guess so.
Oh, what a journey. God. Thank you, everybody, for joining us today. That is the last song. I do have to jet. I've got some other responsibilities. That was heavy, but I'm so glad we detoured and listened to some other songs as well. So that was awesome. So thank you all for joining us. Thank you for the super chat. Hold on. I think I missed a couple. More than a couple. Holy cow. Brittany, thank you. Corazon, Joy again. Joss, Charmaine.
Is that Jive and Joy? Jive and Joy?
Alicia. Jive and Joy? What?
Yeah, remember Joy. I think it was Joy Robinson or Joy.
Joy Robinson.
The other one? Okay, yeah, she was the one that says, I'm 74 and jiving.
Oh, yes, yes.
Jiving Joy, that's her name now, Jiving Joy.
Leisha as well. Wow, thank you so much for the Super Chats. And for the coffees, be sure to check that out. If you haven't already, like yes. and subscribe. We'll be back for more tomorrow. We have Zhao Shen, then Dimash, then Filipino Fridays, then Lara Fabian. The next week, we get a couple more. Our countdown continues, and we will continue to circle back to BTS as we have always promised and always done so. We're just trying to do as best we can to fit in other artists at the same time.
Yes. Thank you guys for joining us today.
Thank you. Have an amazing day, everyone. Bye. Bye, everyone. Oh, I feel it in my heart.